free at last. Kyrandia will now feel my wrath.
Feels good to finally be out of that statue, doesn't it? Remember me? I'm Gunther, your bad conscience. Now that you're free, I say we go kick some butt. Like maybe Kallik and his nitwit grandson Brandon.
Welcome to Kyrandia 3. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. This is episode 1. This game has made me very nervous. I thought about not playing it for a long, long time because I don't like the protagonist of Malcolm, but we're gonna try and get through it together and maybe it'll be okay. Anyway, so first of all, let's talk about the interface here. We got options. We have 10 inventory slots. We have a thing over here that we don't know what it does. We have some points. That's a new thing for the series. We also have normal. And so this obviously changes Malcolm's mood from nice to lying.
I think it's time to start telling more lies.
That's the way to do it. Lie to these idiots.
And then we have normal.
I think I'll just be my normal, sarcastic, nasty-tempered, wonderful self.
Okay, so let's go look at the options very quickly, because one of the things I'm going to do is turn down the volume. We have load a game, save this game, delete a save game. These are all normal, we've seen them before. We have game controls. You can have a walk speed of saunter, hurry. That's about it. I'm going to stick to saunter for the time being. We can have English, French, German, and English. We can have the studio audience, which we haven't heard before, but they laugh in inappropriate places. I'm going to turn them off. I'm going to let you hear one of their laugh track responses, and then we're going to turn them off for good. We have talk interruption, which means that if Malcolm is talking, we can turn them off. We can have dialogue text, which I've turned on for this game, just so you can see it. We have audio controls. I'm going to turn that down. There we go. Okay, we got SFX volume, of course. We've got talking volume, and then we got helium mode. Helium mode on sounds like this. I'm not going to turn it on for too long. I just want you to experience it.
Hasn't King Brandon heard of recycling?
And that's helium mode. I'm going to turn that off. Because we're never going to be able to hear Malcolm properly if I don't. And then we have quit game. And I'm not going to do that quite yet. Okay. So, we have our regular old Kyrandia inventory and all that stuff. If we click on items in the world, we will get responses.
I can't believe all the good stuff people throw away.
I would have thought the laugh track would kick in there, but it won't. So here's this rodent.
Those Kyrandian squares are killers.
And now you've heard the audience, and I'm going to turn them off. That would be under game controls. Audience. Okay. So if we keep clicking on this guy.
Okay, Mr. Squirrel. Let's see how you like a little magic. Hey, what's this? All right. No more fun and games. I don't understand. What happened to my magic?
That's right. No more magic. Frankly, I'm embarrassed to be associated with you.
So I want to say that the process of bringing Malcolm back to life through the striking of his statue with the lightning has left him unable to do or cast magic. That's okay, though. We don't really need magic where we're going. We just need guile and subterfuge, basically. So let's keep trying to bother this guy.
I know you love teasing squirrels, but I'd watch it. Just a warning.
I'm sorry, I didn't actually talk about this, but that's Gunther, your bad conscience. If you'll recall from the intro, he is there giving you terrible advice. In this case, he's giving you sound advice. This game reintroduces an idea that has been in the series all along, and here we have the fruition of that idea.
I'm not afraid of any squirrel, Bill. I told you so.
So generally, anytime Gunther shows up and says, oh, you're pushing a little too far, that's probably your cue to stop. Fortunately, this game has a system that isn't in place in the other games. It has an automatic save. So the minute you do push it a little bit too far, the game will save, and then it will give you a second chance. Okay, so we're back here. The other reason why I've been reluctant to play this game is because of the way it manages inventory. The castle dump over here has a lot of things
I like dumps.
That we can pick up.
I wonder if I can sell this.
Like, for example, the spent nail.
Great. This is all I need.
And this real nail.
I love this place. I've seen flea markets with less good stuff. Hasn't King Brandon heard of recycling? Oh, boy.
Now, you might be wondering why I'm clicking around. That's because there's a whole pile of things that you can find in the dump of the castle.
Great. This is all I need.
I don't need another rusty nail, though.
I just love other people's trash.
This is Herman's saw. It might not look like it, but it is probably Herman's saw. From the first game. Oh, also incidentally, whenever I'm clicking again, I'm interrupting what he is saying. And this is why I've been reluctant to play this game. Because it's a bit hit and miss.
I'd better go home. Doesn't look like they kept any of my things in the castle.
Whether or not you'll find things, and often there's more than one way that you can solve a particular problem.
That Kyrandian killer squirrel looks vicious. I'd like to put one in Kadik's sleeping bag.
First, though, we need to catch one. Haha. Anyway, so one of the good things about this game is that if you walk off and on the screen again,
I wonder if I can sell this.
It would repopulate items in a dump. We do need one of those.
Great. This is all I need.
And we won't necessarily be needing an orange peel. I think that's about the sum of unique items we can get out of there. No, actually it isn't.
Other people's trash.
There we go.
Oh boy.
And I do need two bent nails, so that's okay. Alright. This is the castle. Obviously the castle's been taken over by Brandon. You don't want to go messing with the castle too much because the castle's going to get you into trouble. Obviously, you're not supposed to be around anymore. But we can look at a couple of things here.
Must be King Brandon's new royal banners. Brandon has different tastes than I do. They look like weird ducks.
That's all about that we can do. If we try and go to the gate...
Brandon is such a good guy. Then why does he keep his gate locked?
And we can't go in. You may have noticed that in the background there's a boat, and I'm going to try and get the boat to show up again. Come on, Mr. Boat. You can do it. I guess we're not going to see the boat. Oh, well. It's fine. There we go.
What an enormous moat. I wish I could throw a fireball at the boat sailing down there, just for fun.
So there's a lot of little incidental bits of text and the like that we can discover in this particular game. What's this?
I wish one of these transporters could get me off this island.
Now, this is not a feature that we've seen in this particular game at all, ever in the series. It's new to this particular game. The transporter will take you between two locations. One of the other things that the transporter...
I can't believe they landscaped this area.
The other thing that the transporter can do is it can take stuff that's in your inventory and put it somewhere else. Anyway, we're just here today to explore for the most part. Today's plan is mainly to show you the landscape.
I remember this place.
I'm not gonna walk too far in. Oh no. Okay, well, that's too bad.
Here comes somebody.
We're gonna be in trouble in a minute.
What a ride. Hey, it's you. What are you doing here?
And this is a problem. We don't necessarily really want to be seen by people, but this is Xanthia from the second game. Now that she's here, we may as well talk to her. We'll try and talk to her in all the ways that we can.
Malcolm, what are you doing here?
So I'm loose. Is that a federal offense?
You know I have to report this.
What am I supposed to do? You want me to get back in the statue?
You know you'll have to leave Kyrandia.
Why would I want to stay?
So this is our main objective. We need to get off of Kyrandia. And this will be a thing that we start the game off doing.
You know I have to report this.
What am I supposed to do? You want me to get back in the statue?
Typically, people have two or three lines. We've just exhausted the two or three lines that she has.
You know I have to report this.
Xanthia, I always thought you were a free thinker.
You'll have to leave Kyrandia.
How am I supposed to leave? I don't have a boat or potions or anything.
What about the circus boat? Why can't you audition and juggle or get an outfit and bluff your way on board?
So she's giving us hints here as to how we can get off of Kyrandia. There are several ways to do that. The circus boat is one of them. I'm going to show you the circus boat in this episode.
You know I have to report this.
Xanthia, I always thought you were a free thinker.
You'll have to leave.
I don't have.
What about why or get an out?
Okay. Technically I shouldn't do this. I'll save. So the mood meter, the way it works is that for some puzzles, this is basically a dialogue tree, in case that doesn't seem super obvious. The way this works is there are normally three canned responses for each setting, so normal, nice, and lying. We're going to lie here, and that's not going to set us in good stead with Xanthia in particular. But, you know, it's good to see the responses.
You know I have to report this.
Go ahead. I'm not worried.
You know you'll have to leave Kyrandia.
You bet I'll leave, and I'll never come back to this trash heap of a country.
You know I
have... Go.
You know...
You and I'll never...
Okay, and that's her two canned responses. I'm gonna restore real quickly. And then we're gonna head on off this way. There's a guy over here. We're going to see this guy fairly often. He's just going to crop up all over the car and
here.
What? Where's your mommy? Do you want something, little boy? Where's your mommy?
I'm pretty sure, just listening to that text, that it is basically reverse text. Anyway, again, we can... be nice like we've been. We can be normal.
This should be a fascinating conversation. You've got a tremendous personality, don't you?
This should be a fascinating conversation.
And of course, again, I'm gonna save. We can be mean. Or we can lie, more technically.
Look out! There's a big wolf behind you!
Okay, and that's about all that we can do with that gentleman at the moment. Okay, so there are two ways to go down here. We can go down at the crossroads. It's not obvious, but you can go up.
Those royal mystic idiots used to hold their meetings up there.
And since we're in the process of doing the setup...
weren't there more... oh, that's right.
Sorry, I meant to go up here. Where's up?
Quercus kyrandiana. Those royal mystic idiots used... Quercus, weren't there more trees here before? Oh, that's right. I blew them up.
I love that response. We can go up. Oh, sorry. It's way up into the top of the screen. Normally, screens like this don't work like that.
I should try to explain things to Catherine. She has to know I didn't kill her.
This is news to us because, as far as we know, the whole setup for the first game is that Malcolm killed Brandon, who is the protagonist of the first game, killed both of his parents. So we need to figure out how he is innocent. So let's start by doing that.
Speak with her. Two flowers would be the polite gesture.
So we have seen flowers all over Kyrandia. They look like this. But when we try and get them, they are obviously naturally skeptical of Malcolm. So what we need to do is we need to get two. The easiest place to get them is up here. So I'm just going to go leave and come back. And away you get two, and I'm first going to be nice before we do anything else. There's several ways to get the flowers, none of which are particularly nice. But the one that we have at hand is this one.
Gotcha.
Okay, so let's put both of these things into our inventory. And we need another flower, so... should go back off the screen and come back this way. Oh, okay. Alright, we've scared off the one and it's not going to come back anytime soon. Let's get the other one over here then.
Gotcha. Where do they go?
Goodness knows.
You'd think there'd be street signs here.
Okay, so there is a mild inconvenience with the inventory that I just want to point out very quickly. If I go here, it's not going to bring the inventory up, like at all, because it believes that we're supposed to be going down. But if I go anywhere here, it will bring the inventory up. And that's going to be a bit of a nuisance from time to time. Anyway, let's go this way. We have our two flowers.
Let's see if this flower will awaken Catherine. Almost.
And I'm going to save here, mainly because I want to show you every branch of this dialogue. We're going to be nice to start off with.
Malcolm, how dare you show yourself to me again? How is it that such a brutal, evil murderer can still be free in Kyrandia? You should be rotting in the Dungeon of Dismay.
Okay, So let's discover what we can do to prove our innocence, or let's tell her that we're innocent.
Murderer! You have some nerve.
I'm sorry to disturb you, but I need to prove my innocence.
How can you claim you didn't kill us?
The last thing I wanted was for you or William to be hurt.
Your hand was on the blade.
I was honestly trying to stop it. William knows. Why don't you ask his ghost?
Only a royal seance can bring his ghost back now.
And with that, she's gone. Okay. So that's the sort of canon ending, and I'm going to save that so we don't have to sit through that again. And let's go back in time. And we're going to be normal.
Malcolm, how dare you show yourself to me again? How is it that such a brutal, evil murderer can still be free in Kyrandia? You should be rotting in the Dungeon of Dismay.
And again, we can talk to her, but now our lines will be slightly different.
Murderer! You have some nerve.
Check your facts. I didn't kill you or your husband.
And again, this is just a swing evermore to being mean or lying. So, let's keep going.
How can you claim you didn't kill us?
It was the enchanted knife.
Your hand was on the blade.
I was trying to stop it, you idiot.
And of course, we get no more out of her. Right, so let's do the final path here.
Malcolm, how dare you show yourself to me again? How is it that such a brutal, evil murderer can still be free in Kyrandia? You should be rotting in the Dungeon of Dismay. Murderer! You have some nerve.
I was hoping to apologize.
How can you claim you didn't kill us?
Okay. It wasn't the enchanted knife. It was me.
Your hand was on the blade.
I was helping the bad knife.
So, again, we kind of get a different perspective on it there. But we have two versions of him saying he didn't really do it. So, maybe we should believe him. We don't know if he's a lying protagonist yet, so there's no good way to tell if this is actually the truth, or if the, mean, lying version of Malcolm is telling the actual truth. One thing I do want to comment on very quickly, remember the scene from the first game, and how I loved it so much? I'm not a fan of what they've done with the graphics here. The graphics are pre-rendered backgrounds, Malcolm, and the flower and that sort of thing. They're still sprites. And you can see it especially in the grave over here. With Queen Catherine. And I'm not totally a fan of that look. But oh well. It is just what it is. That's the one thing I wanted to do today. The second thing I want to do is going to require us to get into town. The problem, of course, with town is that town is full of people that we're trying to avoid.
They've renovated the old transporters. I wonder where this one goes.
So we're taking a bit of a chance by going into town.
downtown Kyrandia looks the same as always.
So here we have four buildings on the left.
This won't open the lock. The town hall.
Yeah, the town hall.
These windows are nearly impossible to break. The magician's lodge.
The magician's lodge over there.
The fish cream parlor.
Oh god, fish cream. We're gonna get there, don't worry. And this over here.
The toy factory.
So the place that has the most visible lock is the toy factory.
What a huge lock.
I don't know about you, but it's possible that as well as being a jester, Malcolm is also maybe a locksmith. I don't know.
That worked perfectly.
Okay, so we got some points and we got a bent nail for our trouble. The points in this game are basically throwaway points. The developers wanted to poke fun at games like King's Quest and the like. So anytime you commit like acts of vandalism or the like, you will get points. This was an act of vandalism, so you scored something.
What? The toy factory is closed?
I'll ignore the toy factory for a minute. Because we are nearing the end of the episode. We'll come back to the toy factory, don't worry.
Ah, home at last.
So this is where Malcolm basically hung out before he ended up as a court jester and before he ended up in a stone statue. This is his chest of drawers,
home
his bed,
last.
His book, and a chair and a table over there. Let's start with the bed.
Look what was hidden under the bed. I thought I had lost this.
Okay. This is Malcolm's jester staff. We'll explore that in a separate, different episode. But this is the kind of thing that the Kyra gem was in the first game. Or in the second game, it was Xanthia's potion mixing pot. But in this game, it's just this. And what this does is it's his
feels
jester staff. And it has different effects on different people as you go through the game. The other important thing in this room is this.
Aha! That's where my old family album was.
And this is going to set us up with knowing kind of where Malcolm came from.
I would enjoy looking at that again. You were a cute kid!
It's Malcolm on his third birthday.
You came from good stock. What happened to you? Ha!
So, one of the things that we didn't know about Malcolm before is that he's actually royalty. We got my grandma, Queen Maya, grandpa, King Gregor, former ruler of Kyrandia.
Ah, the wild twins. No wonder Gregor's hair was gray.
That's Mom over there. The Princess Thelia of Kyrandia, Aunt Florine, Mom's twin sister. Okay, so this is Uncle Victor, the wonderful prince. My father, Heinwald. Heinwald is, as you can see, a jester as well. The best court jester ever in Kyrandia. So this is possibly where Brandon picked up his love and desire of being a court jester.
I wonder how much Kallik had to pay to get one of his relatives into the royal family.
Okay, this is Uncle Johannes, married to Aunt Florine, from the Fanulo family. We haven't seen this in any of the other pictures, but these are moving. So they're kind of like the Harry Potter pictures, the moving pictures that they have in their books and the like. This is Kallik Fanulo. They are obviously part of the same family. A dangerous old snake. Malcolm doesn't like Kallik, obviously.
I always like William. Her, I could do without.
Okay, so this is Cousin Bull, otherwise known as King William of Kyrandia. He was the king that Malcolm assassinated in the first game. This is Katie, Catherine, Kallik's daughter, married William.
Something about Brandon always makes me want to hit him.
This is Brandon from the first game. William's son, Prince of Kyrandia. And we have Uncle Alexander, my father's brother, the farming philosopher. Feed your seeds.
Isn't he the one who put some fertilized seeds under Kallik's bathtub? Ah! The seeds grew so quickly, they knocked over the tub
with Kallik inside.
That is an oblique clue for stuff that we'll see later. But this is my cousin Festo, Alexander's adopted son.
No good passport photos in there. I'm not going to lug that heavy book around.
And that is also sort of a oblique clue as to how you can get off of Kyrandia. Anyway, that's the end of episode 1 of the series. I hope that you enjoy it. And I hope that I get over my trepidation playing it. I hope everyone has a wonderful evening. Good night for now.